Umawid ng kagalakan at tugtugin ang gitara at ang kaaya-ayang lira. Himanin niyo ang trumpeta sa ating pagkababay. Sa Diyos tayo'y tumawag, sa ating mga kaaway, tayo ay Kanyang iniligtas. Purihin ang Panginoon, umawit ng kagalakan.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, in this Mass, we remember and pray for Archbishop Michael James Doherty, whose 150th birth anniversary we remember today. Archbishop O'Doherty was the 27th Archbishop of Manila, and he served for about 33 years, part of which were the Second World War. He was the Archbishop during the Japanese occupation. He died in 1949. Let us remember and pray for him, and let us also remember the legacy he left behind. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us acknowledge our sins and ask God's pardon and mercy. Lord Jesus, you have shown us the way to the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you have given us the consolation of the truth. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the good shepherd, leading us into everlasting life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, protector of those who hope in you, without whom nothing has firm foundation, nothing is holy, bestow in abundance your mercy upon us, and grant that with you as our ruler and guide, we may use the good things that pass in such a way as to hold fast even now to those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Let my eyes stream with tears, day and night, without rest, over the great destruction which overwhelms the virgin daughter of my people, over her incurable wound. If I walk out into the field, look, those slain by the sword. If I enter the city, look, those consumed by hunger. Even the prophet and the priest forage in a land they know not? Have you cast Judah off completely? Is Zion loathsome to you? Why have you struck us a blow that cannot be healed? We wait for peace to no avail, for a time of healing, but terror comes instead. We recognize, O Lord, our wickedness, the guilt of our fathers, that we have sinned against you. For your name's sake, spurn us not. Disgrace not the throne of your glory. Remember your covenant with us and break it not. Among the nation's idols, is there that gives rain? Or can the mere heavens send showers? Is it not you alone, O Lord, our God, to whom we look? You alone have done all these things. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us.
Remember not against us the iniquities of the past. May your compassion quickly come to us, for we are brought very low.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us.
Help us, O God, our Savior, because of the glory of your name. Deliver us and pardon our sins for your name's sake.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us.
Let the prisoners sighing come before you. With your great power, free those doomed to death. Then we, your people, and the sheep of your pasture, will give thanks to you forever. Through all generations, we will declare your praise.
For the glory of your name, O Lord, deliver us. Please stand.
Alleluia, alleluia, wikain mo poon nakikinig ako sa iyong mga salita. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus dismissed the crowds and went into the house. His disciples approached him and said, "Explain to us the parable of the weeds in the field." He said in reply, "He who sows good seed is the Son of Man. The field is the world. The good seed, the children of the kingdom. The weeds are the children of the evil one, and the enemy who sows them is the devil. The harvest is the end of the age, and the harvesters are angels. Just as weeds are collected and burned up with fire, so will it be at the end of the age. The Son of Man will send his angels, and they will collect out of his kingdom all who cause others to sin, and all evildoers. They will throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Then the righteous will shine like the sun in the kingdom of their Father. Whoever has ears ought to hear. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
My dear brothers and sisters, our gospel this afternoon, our gospel for today, is the explanation of the parable Jesus told his disciples about the wheat and the weeds. Natatandaan yung talinghagang yon, nagtanim ng mabuting binhi, pero kasabay ng mabuting binhi ay tumubo ang mga damo. And the explanation of Jesus of that parable in today's gospel highlights the fact that in the world, there are good people and there are bad people. There are holy people and there are evil ones. If we look back at the history of humanity, we see this very, very true. We have the group of saints, our favorite saints, your favorite saints, the Blessed Mother, Saint Joseph, Padre Pio, Mother Teresa, Saint Teresa of the Child Jesus, San Pedro Calungsod, San Lorenzo Ruiz. These are all the saints that we pray to and we try to emulate, we try to imitate. We can say that they belong to the good ones. But also, among peoples, there are also bad ones, evil ones. Adolf Hitler, Idi Amin, dictators who killed their fellow men, the corrupt people, both in the government and in the private sector and in the church. We have bad popes, like Alexander the Sixth, if I'm not mistaken, if it's sixth or fourth. But Alexander, bad pope. So, and perhaps even when you try to look at your lives, there are bad parents, there are good parents, there are bad priests, there are good priests, there are good teachers, there are bad teachers. And the Lord is telling us, this is reality. In the world, there are good people, there are bad people. But, my dear brothers and sisters, we should not forget that even in each and every one of us, sa bawat isa sa atin, merong kabutihan at meron ding kasamaan. Saints are not purely, totally holy, just like bad people are not purely and totally evil. Sa ating puso, alam natin, nandoon ang kabutihan at ang kasamaan. Kung minsan, katatapos pa lamang ninyong mangumpisal, kalalabas lamang ninyo sa confession box, no? May nakita kayong hindi nyo gusto, nainis na kayo. May nakita kayong tao na hindi nyo gusto, nagbalik yung galit niyo. Kakukumpisa lang yon. There is a struggle in us between good and evil. Sometimes the good wins, sometimes the evil wins. I remember a story. There is a Cherokee tribe, and in that tribe, Cherokee, Native Americans, no? Indians. There was one Cherokee grandfather who once said to his grandson, "You know, my dear grandson, in us, there are two wolves, animals, two wolves. The one is the good wolf, and the other is the bad work. The good work that is love, respect, kindness, purity, innocence. That's the good work. And then there is the bad work, anger, envy, hatred, jealousy, greed. And they are in constant battle. These two wolves, lagi silang nag-aaway. And so the grandson kept quiet. After a while, the grandson asked his grandfather, "Well, between the two wolves, who wins?" And the grandfather said, "The one that you feed. The one that you feed. Who will win? The one that we feed. Yung pinakakain mo, yon ang magwawagi." My dear brothers and sisters, no one among us is perfect. We have the bad side and the good side. But who will win? It's up to us. It's up to who we feed. Amen.
Please stand.
Jesus Christ has taught us how to enter the kingdom of heaven. Let us pray for the coming of that kingdom, knowing that the Holy Spirit is within us, helping us to pray. To every petition, our response would be, Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the servants of the church may follow God's will and seek the good of those they serve. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those entrusted with dispensing justice and interpreting laws may look to Christ, a source of wisdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That we may wait for God's harvest time and not pass harsh judgment on others, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That the elderly may be sustained by our thoughtfulness and friendship, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That those who have died may be gathered into the harvest of the kingdom, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
In silence, let us pray for our own particular needs. Let us also pray for the intentions offered in this Mass. Lord of heaven and earth, hear the pleas of your people. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, through goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of His name, for our good and the good of all His holy Church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the offerings which we bring from the abundance of your gifts, that through the powerful working of your grace, these most sacred mysteries may sanctify our present way of life and lead us to eternal gladness, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For although you have no need of our praise, yet our thanksgiving is itself your gift, since our praises add nothing to your greatness, but profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord. And so in company with the choirs of angels, we praise you, and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, 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 holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant Michael, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your Son in a death like his may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Siglat ang gulan ko,
Ang Panginoon ang aking pastol, pinagiginhawa ko. Lubos ang Panginoon ang aking pastol, pinagiginhawa ko.
Please stand.
Let us pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The cathedral crypt below the sanctuary is open to the public, and you may go down and pray for the souls of the archbishops buried there, especially Archbishop Doherty. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Eucharist has been offered. Go in the peace of Christ.
Thanks be to God.
Pinagpalang nilikha, ipinagliing walang sala, pusong dalis ay dakila, Maria, ina ng awa.